We have more this week on Apple's upcoming headset. We've been talking quite a bit about this here on the MacCast. It's really expected to be one of the next big things for Apple, along with the Apple Car. This time we have information coming from Morgan Stanley analysts. They say that the project is actually entering a phase that is similar to the period of time that occurred not long before the introduction of the Apple Watch. That was back in 2014. And what they're specifically talking about is the plethora of patents that were filed in advance of that product. This time around, Apple's doing the same thing with a bunch of AR and VR patents. We've been talking about a few of those here on the MacCast. And while they claim that the project is, quote, approaching liftoff, they also noted that Apple has a number of technical challenges that they still need to get over. They're facing a lot of things, right? We have to get all day battery life. They've got to squeeze 5G technologies in there. You've got new chips, probably in the form of a new or updated CPU, cameras, LiDAR, projectors, wave-guided lenses, all into something that Apple is trying to get to be very lightweight and attractive in terms of a pair of glasses or a headset. I would suspect that the first version is going to be a little bit clunkier than Apple really wants, but ultimately they are going to get there. We're expecting to see the first version of a product sometime in 2022, so you know, it is getting close to being done. And Ming-Chi Kuo also weighed in this week with more rumors about what Apple's headset project might bring, specifically this time around talking about the Wi-Fi technology. He's saying both the headset and Apple's upcoming iPhone 14 are going to feature Wi-Fi 6E connectivity. The analyst said that Wi-Fi 6E is going to be required to be able to deliver the high-speed wireless transmissions necessary for the AR and VR experiences that Apple wants to deliver.